Good morning, students. Today I am going to start a new video for class 7 geography. In this video, we are going to start chapter number 4, that is the weathering and the soil formation. Okay, weathering and soil formation, and the topic is the reliefs of the earth and the structure of the earth. So first of all, we should know about the what is the reliefs of the earth. The earth, earth is a spherical surface, and there is a water, air, soil, everything that is required for the survival of life. Okay, everything, earth has a suitable environment, suitable condition, everything that can support the life, so we are on the earth. Which are the essential things that support the life? We are soil, water, air. Soil, water and air. According to this, we divide the earth surface into the four relings. That is the lithosphere, that is the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and the biosphere. Okay, lithosphere related to the soil and the land, and the hydrosphere means the sphere of the water, and the atmosphere means the atmosphere of the sphere of the air, and these three together make a new sphere, that is the biosphere. Biosphere means the sphere of the life. Sphere of life means to survive the life on the earth surface, these three, lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere, are very necessary. It is very important. Okay, now we are going to talk about the different spheres, different reliefs of the earth one by one. Let's see. So first of all, lithosphere. Okay, lithosphere, this is the land sphere, the sphere of the land, and the uppermost layer of the lithosphere is made up of the rocks and the soil. Everyone know what we are living on the earth surface, and this earth surface where the land is called the lithosphere. Okay, lithosphere, the upper part of the earth surface that is made up of the soil, rocks, etc., are called the lithosphere. And the 71% of the lithosphere is under the ocean, and only 29% of the lithosphere is the land. Okay, means lagbhag three-fourth part of the earth is. A three-fourth part of the lithosphere is under the water, and only one-fourth part is land. Now, if we talk about the interior of the earth, means interior of the earth. Interior of the earth. Actually, earth is a sphere of the different concentric sphere, means this year there are concentric layers, different layers of the earth, and we will talk about it after this topic one by one. Means earth is made up of the different concentric layers, and these layers are the crust, mantle and core. We will talk it about it after the after this topic, interior of the earth. Then the when the earth were separated from the sun, when the earth formed, it was a sphere of the fire. And after the due to the change in the temperature, rainfall, atmospheric pressure, etc., it changes, it became cool. And even today, Even today, the interior temperature of the earth is about 6000 degrees Celsius. With very high temperature under the earth, as in the center of the earth, and the radius of the earth is about 6300 kilometer. This is the radius of the earth, and the temperature of the interior part of the earth is about 6000 degrees Celsius. Okay, now let's see the different layers of the earth, that is the crust, mantle and core. Now we are talking about the different layers of the interior part of the earth, and this is the slice of the earth. Like this is earth, and we have cut it, this part from the earth, and this is this part. Okay, this is a single slice of the part of the earth, and we have divided it into different layers. First one is the crust. Means crust is about 35 kilometer up to depth of the earth surface, depth of the earth, and this is not a uniform. There is a two part of the crust. There is the two part of the crust, that is the continental crust and the oceanic crust. Continental and oceanic crust. Okay, the continental crust, which is made up of the only rocks and the soil, and this part is known as the continental crust, because this is the fully land. Okay, and the part of the crust that is under the ocean, means this part is under the ocean. This is also a crust, but this part is under the ocean. So this is known as the oceanic crust. The thickness of the crust is 35 kilometer in the continental crust, and the thickness is about 8 kilometer in the oceanic crust. Okay, the surface of the crust is not even. Means you know highest point, highest elevation on the earth surface on the crust is Mount Everest, which is about 8848 meter above the sea level, and the Mariana Trench. Mariana Trench is the deepest point on the earth surface, that is the Mariana Trench, which lies in the Pacific Ocean. Means this is the deepest, and Mount Everest is the highest elevation on the earth surface. Means we can easily say the crust of the earth is not unevenly distributed. It is not even. Actually, this is uneven. Okay, means there is a mountains, plateaus, oceans, everything. So this is not even. Okay, now the next one is the crust, the continental crust of the earth. Continental crust means, if you talk about the continental crust, it is the made up of the two main elements, that is silica and aluminium. Silica and aluminium. So this continental crust is also known as SiOl. Si for silica and Al for aluminium. This continental crust, the other name of the continental crust is SiOl, and the oceanic crust, which is made up of the silica and the magnesium. Oceanic crust is made up of silica and magnesium. So this part, means the continental crust, is also known as SIMA, SIMA. Si for silica or Ma for magnesium. Okay, means this is also known as SIMA. Now let the next layer, that is the mantle. Mantle, this is about to 2900 kilometer from the Earth's surface. It is 29 kilometer below the Earth's surface, means from here to here, means this is about 2900 kilometer, and from the after 25 kilometer to 3900 kilometer, this is the mantle. And we also divide the mantle in the two part, that is the upper mantle and the lower mantle. Okay, the upper mantle, which is about to 700 below the crust, 700 below the Earth's surface, and after the 700 to 2900, this is the lower mantle. Okay, the upper mantle and the lower mantle. Let's see one by one. The upper mantle of the Earth is partially melted. Partially melted means there is a soft layer within the this part. Okay, and this layer, means you can say this is a molten state, and there is a groundwater, everything. जो भी यहाँ पर molten state में वो upper mantle में आता है. एंड इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं एस्थेनो स्फीयर, ए एस ई एच ई, एस्थेनो स्फीयर. ओके, एस्थेनो स्फीयर मींस यू कैन से द क्रस्ट इज अबाउट, लुक्स लाइक इट इज फ्लोटिंग ऑन द एस्थेनो स्फीयर. ओके, मींस दिस इज द व्हाट, अपर मेंटल, एंड अपर मेंटल इज पार्शियली मोल्डन, मींस नॉट फुल्ली मोल्डन बट इज पार्शियली molten. Okay, as we go in the interior of the Earth, the temperature and the density of the material increases, means in the inner surface, in the interior of the Earth, the all thing, all substances are in a molten state or solid state also, due to it depends upon the temperature and the pressure. Means if there is a high temperature and low pressure, then it will be in the molten state. But if there is a high temperature and high pressure, it may be in solid state. Looks like inner core, there is a high maximum temperature in the core, but this is in the solid state. Okay, now upper mantle is, the depth of this part is about 670 kilometer, 670 kilometer, and the lower part, means this part, is about 2200 kilometer. The thickness of the lower mantle is about 2200 kilometer, and thickness of the upper mantle is 670 kilometer. Okay, now next part, that is the core, means this, from this to this, this is a core. Okay, the depth of the core start from the 2900 kilometer from the Earth's surface to 51 kilometer from the Earth's surface. Means this part is known as the outer core. Means core is also divided into two parts, that is the outer core and the inner core. The outer core is also in the molten state due to the high temperature, and there is inner part, the innermost part is called inner core, is in solid state. Okay, the innermost layer of the Earth is called the core, and it is about 3500, means from there to here, it is about 3500 kilometer. And then means the thickness of the core is 3500 kilometer, and the outer core is in a molten state, and molten state, and this is the solid. But due to the pressure of the all the layers above, due to the high pressure, due to this all layers, this part is in the solid state due to the high pressure. And you know, the maximum and the heavier elements that has hexagon in the center of the earth. So this the heavy all elements like the you can say nickel, iron, this lie in this part. So this inner core is also known as nipe, means the continental crust is called as here, the ocean crust is called as sima, and this layer has also many elements like iron, aluminium, silica, everything. Means solid, and this part is in solid state due to two reasons, that is the high pressure and due to the heavier element. Okay, and so this part is known as nipe. Now next in the next video we will talk about the rocks and the different types of rocks. Have a good day.